It has been an interesting week, geologically speaking, on Russia's Kamchatka Peninsula. While the nation's more than 15,000-foot-high, rapidly growing Klyuchevskoy volcano has been producing continuous 40,000-plus-foot-high eruption plumes, the lava field and explosive activity at the Krasheninnikov volcano's first historical eruption has been simultaneously occurring. Since producing a paroxysm that resulted in violent strombolian activity and the construction of a summit cinder cone, Klyuchevskoy's elevated eruptive rate has fed an unusually long lava flow. This lava flow has, in only 10 days' time, traveled 5.4 kilometers or 3.4 miles on the volcano's west-southwest flank. The lava in the last 48 hours reached a series of glaciers from the neighboring Kamen volcano, causing a series of explosive interactions to occur. However, it is not these explosions that are generating an unusually high and sustained eruption plume, but rather a change in the nature of the ongoing eruption at Klyuchevskoy's summit vent. Activity has shifted, possibly temporarily, from a violent strombolian eruption to a volcanian eruption with a sustained ash plume. This plume has been continuously reaching heights upwards of 40,000 feet elevation for a full 36 hours, at least as of the writing of this video. Its eruptive output has increased alongside with its gas emissions, creating a 350-kilometer or 217-mile-long eruption plume easily visible from the faraway Bering Island. Whether eruptive activity at Klyuchevskoy will further increase is uncertain, but if you want my opinion-based speculation, I actually favor a decrease in activity to soon happen. After many of Klyuchevskoy's more explosive eruptions in recent times, the volcano has often thereafter either ceased erupting for a time or erupted at a far reduced rate. Regardless, its basalt lava flow has now covered an area of 0.76 square kilometers. Heading 160 kilometers to the south, the Krasheninnikov volcano in the last few days has undergone the opposite of Klyuchevskoy, that being a reduction in the now week-long eruption's intensity and output. Eruption plumes stopped continuously reaching altitudes of 20,000 feet or greater late on August 6, and have remained below this ever since. It might be the case that what was explosively fragmenting to erupt as ash is now being effused as lava, but I personally interpret a true reduction in eruptive output, especially due to a declining rate of sulfur dioxide emissions. Regardless, a 2,200-meter-long fissure cutting through Krasheninnikov's northern cone and north-northwest flank have continued to output presumably basaltic material, involving between 3 and 10 eruptive vents, as at any moment not all of these are still continuously erupting. Activity is largely phreatomagmatic at this stage, with occasional lava bombs being ejected, but the most interesting aspect of the ongoing eruption is how rapidly its lava field has expanded. Since August 2nd, lava has emerged from multiple fissure vents to feed three lobes of advancing molten rock, one to the south, one to the east, and one to the north-northwest. The north-northwest lobe currently appears to be the main lobe at the present with the highest rate of motion per day, although lava has also almost completely filled the inner crater of Krasheninnikov's northern cone, with material also spilling over to the east. In total, 1.57 square kilometers or 0.61 square miles have been covered in molten rock so far, involving what I at a minimum estimate to be at least 7 million cubic meters of lava. Krasheninnikov's decline in activity could stabilize, but generally speaking, eruptions of this nature start on a high note and thereafter slowly decline. As for other volcanoes in Kamchatka, while Bezimiani, Kurumsky, and Shevlech continue to erupt like usual, there may have actually been a decrease in unrest at the Manovsky volcano, as I have been unable to spot satellite-detected thermal signatures there for 4 days now. And at the Kamboni volcano, the intensity of its ongoing earthquake swarm has continued to decline, which, as you might have guessed, is a good sign. Stay tuned for more updates. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Coco Faye, for supporting my work.